The village I live in has got one of the longest names in the world. Don't say you want me to say it. Llamar Pushgwingish go gerich mwyn drobysh San Cecilia go go goch. My name's Francesca, I'm 26 years old and I'm from Anglesey. I work as a finance officer and claims officer in a little town called Llangefni. Oh my God, how would I describe myself? I'm quite a friendly and outgoing person. I'm very loud. I'd say I come across as probably quite confident, but I'm actually not that confident. I fell from a height, which ended up with me breaking my back, and I'm now paralysed from the waist down. I was in hospital for 3 months altogether, which is quite good because they expected me to be there for 6 months. Yeah. But I was like, I'm not staying here. But I remember being in the hospital and they started ripping my hair extensions out of my head because they needed to do a scan of my head. And I just remember the pain from that. I don't remember pain from my injury, my back. It was just my hair is hurting. I can't remember much of it because of all the medication I was on and things. But my dad said about 4 days in, I said, oh, it's just something I've got and I've got to get on with it. They introduced me to my wheelchair and on the same day I went to my first physio session. And then as the weeks go by, you have to learn how to dress yourself again, how to manage your body. And it's like starting from the beginning again. It's like being a toddler all over again. And you feel a bit stupid because you have to learn the simplest of things again. But it's just something you have to do. And it eventually comes the norm again. The first time I went out after coming from hospital, my friends held a little fundraiser for me in the local cricket club. It was a good night. It was good to be socialising again with my friends after not seeing a lot of people for so long. I was picturing it in my head as if I wouldn't be able to move around and things like that. But I've managed to move around. Everything, the doors are wide enough. The main bathroom in the house is upstairs, so I can't get to that. We've got a shower downstairs, but I can't fit into that now. So at the minute, I'm having a full body wash by the sink in the morning. I've had to move my bedroom from upstairs to downstairs because obviously I can't get upstairs anymore. I've not found it that hard in the home itself. It's when I get outside because we've got a gravel drive. That is very challenging. It does take me longer than it used to get ready, but you do get faster with time. Like to begin with in the hospital, when I had to learn how to get dressed myself again, it took me 25 minutes in the beginning. Now I can do it in 2 minutes. So it does get better with time. I just still take really long to do my makeup and stuff, but that was what it was like anyway before. Everything seems to be going okay so far. I've gone back to work. I've started driving again. So it's slowly coming back together. I definitely want to keep active in my chair. I'm going to meet the Disability Sports Officer for Wales and a physio from the Health Board who should be able to tell me more about what sports are available, how they can help me post-injury and how I can go about starting a sport. Elias Park. Try and find our way there. I've had a load of like randomers, no not randomers, but why don't you just use an electric chair instead of a manual one? But I've got my arms, I can still push. I've got them, I still want to use them.
The main thing for us when trying to get people involved in sport is just telling them that it's the enjoyment aspect. Mm. We want people to have fun, socialise and basically just build their confidence and, yeah, and do anything that they can to enjoy the benefits that sport can bring. Yeah. So is there anything that you may have seen or heard about that you'd like to have a go in?
Wheelchair basketball.
Wheelchair basketball is one of the fastest growing sports.
How do I go about starting wheelchair basketball? Do I just go to the club?
What we can do is put you in touch direct, or we could even come down for the first session, so introduce you in person. Sport's got a huge amount of benefits. So if you think about that team cohesion, the confidence building, it's all the subtle little pieces of advice and that sort of seeing role models. It can have a huge impact on that person beyond the sport, and that's what we really try to look at, is using sport as the vehicle to help that person to potentially reduce their isolation, build confidence, increase your strength, flexibility, and ultimately make you a happier, well-rounded person.
So we found at the moment not many disabled people are physically active. So it's only around 4% of the population in North Wales do sport or physical activity.
Why is the percentage so low?
But disabled people, I think, face perhaps more barriers than non-disabled people. So whether it's transport access, accessing appropriate equipment, or some of the barrier might even be the awareness of clubs. So you think most non-disabled people know they can go down to a leisure centre or they can go to a sports club. But how do you feel about getting involved in sport?
I want to get involved, but I don't know how far I could go.
Yeah. How confident do you feel to go and try a different sport?
I do feel confident about it because I've always been into sports, so I will give anything a go anyway. But I'm very competitive and I don't like losing. So
we want to give you the different methods, ways that you can get involved, and hopefully not just be active for the next 6 weeks or 6 months, but not the next 10, 20 years.
I had no idea what to expect going into that meeting, but I found it really useful because now I know how to get into sport and who to speak to if I ever need any help with anything.
So we're going to Anglesey Hawks Basketball Club this evening, where I'll meet Sophie Cargill, the co-captain of GB Women's Wheelchair Basketball Team. Her injury seems quite similar to mine, and I'm looking forward to meeting an active wheelchair user and asking lots of questions about what her experiences were and how sport has helped her.
So I was involved in a car accident in 2010, so it's been about 7 years now since I've been in a wheelchair.
What level of injury are you?
So my level of injury is T6, so it affects like from my waist down, like a lot of my core and obviously my legs as well.
How did you manage after your accident? Did you find things easy to adjust to or not?
I think obviously when something like this happens to you, you go through like a traumatic accident, it is hard to adjust, like nobody's going to tell you that it's easy.
How did you get into sport and has it helped you with your day-to-day life?
So I first got into wheelchair basketball just playing at my local club. It was the Leeds Spiders, played for the club for a year, and so it just kind of felt right that after that backup course I went on and I'd kind of got my confidence back. And then I ended up getting scouted by just some of the GB staff. And then really my progression from that was quite quick into the GB squad.
How long would it take me to learn wheelchair basketball?
I'll give you my personal experience. When I first showed up at my first training session, transferred into like a sports chair, which felt like completely alien to me. I couldn't even like dribble the ball and push at the same time. Like I found that all really hard. If there's any advice I could give you, it would just be to persevere, like no matter what. The people around you will support you and be able to help you with like learning the different skills and tricks and stuff that you can do and getting to know the game. It'd be really cool if you want to try mine out, see what it's like. It's probably really different to what you're sat in at the moment. So if you want to give it a try, like feel free.
It's so mad how like fitted it feels, if you know what I mean. Can I spin on this?
Before I tried Sophie's sports chair, I didn't know that lightweight and such well-fitting chairs existed and how easy they are to push. I have an occupational therapist visiting me today to give me a better understanding of my injury, medical requirements, and what my priorities should be when I'm looking for a chair.
What are the things within this chair that work for you and what doesn't work for you? Think about the home environment and thinking about what it is that you want to achieve.
bang into a lot of things and my feet start off with.
Like, so they're sticking out?
Yeah.
All right, so at the moment, it's too big, it's too heavy.
Can't lift it.
What about the shape of it?
Bulky.
That's too bulky. Okay, so we need to be thinking about having something that's a bit more of an open frame so that you can sit and you can be stable, you can be safe in the car, but you have things like the wheels will come off, like the shape of the frame, so you can get it across your body. The chair that you're looking for is a more active chair, a lighter chair, one that actually fits around your needs. Because mm-hmm. at the moment, you're fitting into a chair that has a purpose and has a place, but at the moment doesn't seem to be fitting your lifestyle.
After seeing the OT and the mobility advisor, I feel very informed about my product that I'm going to be having, and I feel like they weighed up the pros and cons that you can get with different settings that you can have on your wheelchair. When I was back in hospital when I first had my injury, I didn't know what my life was going to be like. I did kind of think, I'm not going to be able to do this, I'm not going to be able to do that. But since coming out, you realise that there's so much to do. When I met up with Sports Disability Wales, they were helpful because it showed me what other sports there are except for wheelchair basketball, because that's the one that I'd heard of mostly. After meeting Sophie and after being in training with her that we had over in Anglesey Hawks, since then I've kept going and I really enjoyed it, and I had my first basketball game last weekend.
What we'll do, we'll just talk you through the sort of adjustability and the functions on the chair. First thing we've got is a height adjustable foot plate. The reason you might want to adjust your foot plate, if you change cushions for a thicker or thinner cushion or something, you might just want to adjust your foot plate accordingly. These two clamps here are the pins to locate your front wheel on, which we'll come to in a moment and have a look through. So obviously when we get you sat in the chair, we'll make sure everything's okay. And if you need to do any adjustments today, we can do that while I'm here. So it's a two position lock. So when it's upwards, it's locked and it won't go anywhere. It will also lock in the down position for is when you're doing your car transfers, it doesn't mean your backrest is going to be flapping around. This is your front wheel. When you're outside or it's really bad terrain or gravelly surfaces, you'll either be doing lots of wheelies trying to go over them. It extends the wheelbase of your chair, so it makes it longer, which means it will roll easier. Other than that, how are you feeling? You've been sat in the chair for 10, 20 minutes
now? Well, I feel comfortable.
You feel comfortable?
Yeah.
Over the next hour or two, we'll just review it, and if we need to adjust anything, we can fine tune it.
Today, I've got my new chair, and I got to the car, and Dan showed me how to get my chair in and out. No, that felt good to know that I can go places on my own soon as the dog doesn't have to follow me everywhere. Now that I've had my lightweight chair, I'm looking forward to be able to see how more independent I could be with it than what I was when I had my NHS chair, because it was so heavy. The one I've got now is light, it fits properly, my feet aren't sticking out miles in front of me. It's all tucked in nice and neat, so hopefully it'll help a lot with future things.
She's sitting up straight.
Oh yeah, you are. So how do I fold it up?
Can we put it in the can?
You don't need to. I can put it in the can now.
The thing with Fizz is that she hasn't like changed one bit. She's still utterly annoying. With all of us girls, the most thing we're proud of is that how positive she is. I think any advice given to anyone else, if they're friends-wise, just be there, and that's the most you can do.
She's just like, you know, getting on with life, like nothing's changed, but she's still mad as ever.
A nurse told me in hospital in Stoke, I remember me and my wife were sitting there with big glum faces and, you know, thinking this is the end of the world and all this. And the nurse said to me, he said, do you know, he said, why are you so upset? Just look at it this way, it's a new beginning. And I've stuck in my mind that. And it's a true thing, new beginning.
I've surprised myself in the way that I've coped with things since my injury. I feel like I'm stronger than what I thought I'd be. I've managed to
cope with things quite easily. I've got the attitude where I think I've got to do it, so I just go out and do it. Yeah, I've surprised myself in a lot of different ways, I think.